こいつの言う通り。早よ逃げ。
何言ってるのよ。私はもうこれ以上、家族が死ぬのは嫌だ。好きな人が死ぬのも嫌だよ。
分かってる。
だったら今すぐ。
うっさいわボケ。なあわしらもうボロボロや。どうせ助かる時間がないや。
でも
一生に一度や。First
is strong with chat on this one, evidently.
死ね。
来
い。 No demon blade this time. Byuji Goda, second patriarch. Gojo.Home your lights. Oh-ho!Punch in that direction. Oh wow! First death of the game. I saw it coming and I really should have probably healed, but whatever. Oh wow! Oh, bad end. Okay. Oh dude!Oh, if we die, oh crap. Well then, heal you fools. Come on, Kiryu, use your absolute power. Yes, and I am back. Was away having a little try of my Irish whiskey that I got for my birthday. Much sweeter than scotch. Yeah, it usually is. It's also a blend. Oh, wow.Oh, wow. Well, yeah, we'll definitely skipping the cutscenes now. Well...Who knew? That's good. That, well played, RGG. That would have been really annoying otherwise. Okay, right. So,
Oh.
Hail, Skellipuppy. And cheers. Oh, I can't skip this bit. Okay. Temple Bar Whiskey, 12 years old. I will bear a knife. Hey, Lencio, how's it going? Apart from the fact that we've just been knocked back about an hour and a half. Or at least, okay, maybe about 40 minutes. Also, hey, I'm just Razor, welcome. There we go. Okay, we're speedrunning this now. The
he says as he completely locks that one. Imagine if it was permadeath. Oh, that would have been very sad. Really annoying. In fairness, we had a save anyway, so he could have easily gone back. I mean, the thing that took up most of the time was the cutscenes anyway, so we should be alright. Remember to heal. Yes, okay. I will remember to heal next time. I saw my health going down and I thought, oh, I should probably heal, but I didn't realize it was going to be permadeath. I didn't realize that it was going to be I die and then I'm back to the start of the chapter. A permadeath that also deletes all of your cells. That would be unfortunate. That would have been pain and misery, and I'm not sure I would have wanted to play a game like that. Okay, I would have played a game like that, but oh good lord, I don't think I would have done it on Legend if that was the criteria. Or maybe, no, actually I probably would have, but I would have just been a lot more curt. And I wouldn't be prattling around like I am at the minute. Like I didn't in the main story. Man in Black. I wonder if that's the same Man in Black who kept sending us texts at the start of the game. That would have been interesting. mean, seriously. Man in black. Maybe he is the one who kept sending me those messages. Maybe he was... Oh, that's pretty meta. He's the one who sent me the messages teaching me how to play the game. So I could surpass him. That was his fine... That he wasn't part of the Jin 1 Mafia. That was his final test. His final test to see if I truly was the Dragon of Dojima. At least that's my headcanon for it. I mean, I wasn't watching. I would be convinced that you died on purpose to fill time. That was me dying because I was prattling around like an idiot. How many separate cutscenes are there? All right, that was just all one cutscene. Kakugo wa dekitoru yaro ne. Just headbutt him to death. His nose must be utterly destroyed. Bonk. And then he headbutts his own sword. There we go. Man, these cutscenes really were long, weren't they? Koko de owari ni shimashou. For once, I didn't get hit by it. Oh. Something was playing Dark Souls. Just gave up at that point. I've been thrown, I'm defeated. Okay, we'll be serious now. Yeah. much up a heal when I did. Man, this is really brutal. That QTE was a one-hit KO.
お前だけ逃げろ。
ってるの？
俺はもう動けない。
諦めないで、私が背負っていくわ。
お前だけ逃げるんだ。
分かった、それなら私もここにいる。あなたを置いて逃げられないわ。
俺のことは放っておけ。
そんなことできない。
早く早く逃げるんだ。
うるさい、私はあなたと一緒にいるの。
Oh, right. Copyright music. Oh, come on, game. I will let you know, I'm going to have to talk over it at least a bit so I can claim, what is it, fair use. But you know why I have to talk over the cutscene here. As we watch a Yakuza and a police officer make out in front of a bomb as her dead brother lies nearby and his policeman friend is sat in a helicopter screaming at them. Oh dear. Though props to the pilot, considering he was flying amongst all of those cranes, I most certainly would have crashed into at least one of them. Or all of them.
Haruka-chan のこと裏切っちゃったね。
そうだな。でもきっと Haruka なら分かってくれるさ。
うん、そうやね。しっかりもんやしね。
Go back to the car scene.
でもこんなにあったかいのは初めてや。
The end, but it isn't, and we've got copyright protected news. Oh, there we go. The blocking is removed, and I can't skip the credits. No, seriously. I can take a screenshot of the credits. Hold up. Well, there we go, that's legend mode done. No, seriously, I cannot skip. We are watching the credits. Like, I can't speed them up, I can't slow them down. Well, good job! Good job, RGG. But I suppose we'll just listen to the music as I talk. Oh no, I thought you could. So did I, but there we go. I mean, don't get me wrong. This is a fantastic game. Everyone here above my head. Bloody amazing. Very good. Very talented people. Thank you for such an amazing game. This is easily one of my favourite games of all time now. But, yes, the copyright music, though it's awesome. It is awesome. It is part of it. Does the angry band hammer swings very close to my head and it's a rather an uncomfortable feeling. So I'm going to have to talk continuously to make sure that I have changed the music, because who would want to copy this music from this particular gameplay only to hear my voice like the worst radio DJ in the world talking over and over and over and over and over it. So yes, either which way, there we go. Ring announcer Kai Grant. I wonder, never mind. Grant again. Shintaro Kazama. Oh, Kazama! Oh, it's the last name Shintaro. Okay, fair enough. I'm sure that I knew that at some point. Nope. fairness, I'm going to try and find this on Spotify later. This is an awesome song. Even if I will never be able to listen to it ever again without thinking of Pandemonium, because that's where it's from. Well, that's the one that was playing in the game. And then the slow one was from the same artist, and yeah, that's just his backing to Kiryu and Sayama at that point.
Oh, Jordan Bennett.
But there we go. That, it's not popped yet, but there is our legend run of Yakuza Kiwami 2 done. The last Yakuza game we're going to platinum, unless Like a Dragon's really easy to platinum, but I don't think it is. All the other ones will require a legend playthrough, and I will not be doing them, because this, as you've seen, it requires at least a week or two of streams of us just retreading the same story that we've done already. So, yeah. Also, I don't know, it sort of loses its luster when I can't run around and prat around in Kamurocho for about 4, 5, 6 streams doing all the completion list. The completionist is a massive part of why I love these games, apparently. But don't get me wrong, the story's amazing, but I gave up mainlining stories in games a long time ago for this very reason. The final challenge, talk to survive the DCMA, pretty much. No, down in YouTube, I'm not big enough on YouTube that they can hit me with it. They hit me with a copyright claim and say, "Ooh, you're using our music, give us all your revenue." And I turn around and say, "Yeah, sure, here is £0 and zero pence of the revenue I've made on all of these videos on my street, on my channel. Congratulations, YouTube. You have earned bugger all from me. Well done." So yeah, I don't know if this is a DCMA one as well, or if this is actually a thing. But we'll keep talking anyway. But yeah, no, I mean, don't get me wrong, the story's amazing. I love the story, but But the main reason I gave up mainlining games a long time ago is it's okay to just go through and play all of the story, and some people like that. Me, I sort of found after a while, just play through the story, play through the story, play through the story, and I sort of lost my will to play games just because it felt like busy work. And then I started doing these streams, and I started 100%ing things, and I suddenly realised, oh, good lord, there is a lot under the surface of this game. And then I realised, well, if I play the game long enough, then I get really overpowered, and then I can just flatten everyone in the late game, and that feels kind of good. So that's what we do here, because we've just flattened everyone in the late game, apart from Ryuji in the final fight, because after all we've been through, I thought I at least owed him that much to have a fist-on-fist fight against him. We had sword-on-sword in his first fight, and we had fist-on-fist in the second, and that is the moral of the story and how Christmas came to be. Apart from it isn't, that's a blatant lie. I'm just making up random bollocks now to talk over the music that keeps playing, because I really don't want to get DCMA. You finished the game! Yes, it is Journey's End! We have finished the game! Not only that, we have platinumed it. We finished the game a few weeks back, but we have platinumed it. We have done, well, we will as soon as the platinum pops, but for now, we have done every sub-story, every completion list item, every completion list, primary and secondary. We've got every weapon, every gear item, we have done every single bouncer mission on all three difficulties. We have done all of the story of Clan Creator and all but the last of the Clan Creator bonus missions, because I refused point blank to do the last Clan Creator bonus mission. That is right up there with the stupid on-rails gun section from Yakuza Kiwami. Never going to happen. Never going to do it in any way, shape, or form. I point blank refuse. But we've done all of Club 4 Shine, including the Golden Statue. Still an amazing moment. We have finished the story in its entirety. We've also played the game on Legend Mode. We have done every single trophy. We have upgraded Kiryu to maximum. We've unlocked every one of his abilities, every one of his everything. And upgraded every one of his stats. Limit broke every one of his stats. I'm just listing things now to talk, and also I'm going to have to do this when we get to the No Holds Barred after the credits. So, yes. We have done everything. There is nothing left for us to do in this game. New Japan Pro Wrestling, we beat up some wrestlers, and thank you, Skeller Puppy, for the stretch redeem. I have not done one of them for a while, and ow, my shoulder. Well, there we go. Congratulations, production team on Yakuza Kiwami 2. Congratulations to
the localization team who have once done, once again done an absolute fantastic job of all of it. There we go. Also, wafer of the moment. Sayama, Yakuza Kiwami 2, why not? She deserved the wife of the moment in this game. She was amazing. I like her. She sort of struck me as sort of, there we go, Sin. That's the S-I-M. They're the ones who have done all of the singings. The singing even. Sayama, what was I saying? Yes, Sayama, she reminds me a lot of Faye Valentine from Cowboy Bebop. I know, different characters, different actors. Look, she starts off as this really brash character, and then she warms up. She goes on a character journey. She has character development, and it's amazing. Same with Ryuji, same with everyone. The entire cast of this game has just been... Oh! I love these games. Also, the fact that we got a lot of Kiryu and Majima was just amazing. Majima was just on point in this game. Hopefully he continues to make appearances. But something tells me that he might not, but I don't know. I think somebody in chat mentioned it once, but we'll soon find out, won't we? Oh god, I can finally stop talking. Hey, what's next on the list? Deathloop. Deathloop is our next destination. And then Yakuza 3 remastered.
Arigato ne. Watashi zutto wasurenai yo.
Sama, Nishiki, somebody, and... Oh, no, Kazama, Nishiki.
あの爆弾が偽物だったとは.
Oh, Yumi,
Terada.
Okay.
やつが言っていた通り, Takashima のことは, 心から信用しちゃいなかったのさ.
そうだな. 最初から爆弾の信管は抜かれていたわけだしな.
I wonder if this is a running thing for all the games now, where the post-credits will, where the endings will always be Kiryu and Date having a conversation.
しかし、爆弾が起動した時はどうなるかと思ったぜ。ああ。だがあの時、寺田の判断がなければ、高島の思い通りになっていただろう。お前、あの爆弾が爆発しないことが分かっていたのか？いや、分からなかった。
だが奴を最後に信じてくれと言った。お前に何を信じて欲しかったんだろうな。多分風間のおやっさんへの気持ちだったんだと思う。今思えばな。なるほどな。その言葉に嘘はなかったってわけだ。ああ。
Hi, Fu-chan. Do you think you should get a bit more of an ending for the Legend finish? I do. But I'm not going to complain because it meant that we got the full ending anyway. A part of me wants to say yes, but another part of me also wants to say, you know what? Props to RGG for having the legend as just that, an extra, a harder challenge. There we go. Same font I use for the entire channel, by the way. There we have it! Oh, wait a minute. No, we don't have it. There we go. Legend. Time! 99 hours, 59 minutes, and 59 seconds. Enemies down, 6,871. Money gained, a lot less than we previously did, though it's still in the millions. Completion items collected, 226 of 303. But that doesn't poxy matter, because we've already done all of that in the main playthrough. Obtained 1 million! We're finally at 30,000! I was complaining about that last stream, and we've suddenly got it. Okay, cool. We are now at a nice round 30 mil, and there we have the Dragon Trophy earned. There we will save the game, and there is our Platinum. Imagine that. Oh, Gordon Bennett. No. Okay. I will. I can't give the answer. I legitimately can't, unfortunately, Nintendo. I mean, I'll give you a bit of Majima for free, but unfortunately I can't do the full 5 minutes of our dear mad dog of Shimono on the simple principle that I have a whole no hot bar to do, I'm afraid, so we will have to leave that until some other time, but you will get your points redeemed. There we go. Right, collect, complete all, and... It's there, and take a swig of whiskey. Hail, stray girl! And cheers! sorry, stray girl, champ! But don't worry, Nintendo. After all, we've still got several more journeys to go, and trust me, the Majima voice is not going anywhere. Oh, I really, really need to keep practicing it. The Kiryu voice, but how will I ever sound as awesome as Kiryu-chan? Anyway, right, where was I? Oh, yes. There we go. What? No more whiskey redeem. No, that was the only one. Wait, no, we'll keep the whiskey redeem, but you can't, unfortunately, redeem more whiskey because the whiskey redeem was redeemed. If you want to blame somebody, blame the Muppets in chat, who when I first put the whiskey redeem in, decided to spam it about 6 times in a row. And it made me realize, yes, probably having that as an unlimited redeem is not the smartest idea. Now hold on a minute. Before we do anything, there we go. Take a swig. Well, cheers, Spud. Oh, also, hail Spud! Welcome! Sorry, I forgot to say hello. Right, there we go. There, look! Yakuza Kiwami 2 Platinum. There we have it. Ultra Rare, 2.4% of players achieve this, and right beneath it, the Majima Factor. Who doesn't love that sight? Right, there we go. Awesome. So, the only thing left for us to do... Also, what is with the... Okay, so... With that said... Only thing left for us to do is... Ooh, hello. Oh, no. Yeah, no, that's what I intended to do. And then we do that. Then we do that. Now, we're not ending just yet, because... We are at journey's end. We have finished our journey. Well, we technically finished it a couple of weeks ago, but we've done the extra bits. We've got our flat. So, all that's left for us to do is to bring everything to a nice summary and a close and get ready for our next journey. For those of you who are wondering and those of you who asked, our next destination is Deathloop, a game that I have intended to play since seeing it, I think it was the PS5. A PlayStation event thing prior to its release, and I said I want to play that game, and then, well, Yakuza and Breath of the Wild got in the way. So yes, Deathloop is certainly the next. It's definitely the next game on our list. How long will we be playing Deathloop? I do not know. What do we expect from Deathloop? I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to 100% it. I don't know if I'll complete it. I've looked at some of the trophies, maybe some of the achievements. Maybe we'll go off the achievement list in Steam, or maybe we'll just do a normal 100% run by my criteria and just do everything in the game. I don't know. We'll figure it out as we go along. I'm thinking if there's an upgrade system, every upgrade, every side story, and the main story, and we'll probably leave it at that. Something similar to what we did with Cyberpunk, I'm sure. But before then, you should be able to finish Deathloop by Christmas. It is me, Palomino. It is me. So maybe New Year. But anyway, with that said, let us get this let's get this no holds barred done and dusted as I waffle uselessly for the next 5 minutes. So, okay, Ezio, let's cut it around about here. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another rendition of No Holds Barred, our sort of bookends to these journeys we go on here on the channel. As you can see, well, you can't actually see because it's not showing up, but as you can see by the title down below, we have just wrapped up our journey through the world of Yakuza Kiwami 2. A game that's easily classified now as one of my favourites of all time. This is an absolutely amazing game. It is the continuation of our Yakuza franchise run. We have platinumed, at this time of recording, Yakuza 0, and we have 100% Yakuza Kiwami, which, for reasons in the previous No Holds Barred video on the matter, is explained why we didn't platinum that. This is a game that I was unsure about platinuming until we finally got into it properly, and then I realised, yes, I, for once in my time, I will break my one-run rule and we will actually sit here and we will play the entire game through twice, once on hard mode to get to through the entire story and get the main bulk of our 100% run done, and then once through on Legendary where we just went New Game Plus with everything we'd unlocked in the main game and the premium adventure, and then we completely curb stomped everyone through a speed run, as speedy as I am actually, in any instance even, completing this game. So yes, when I say completing, we've not completed it, I'll get into that. But anyway, of the game, boy, first of all, this one has been made in Dragon Engine, RGG Studios' own custom-built games engine. I must admit, it does have some janky moments. Sometimes you do get caught on things, sometimes the controls do seem to be a bit skew-whiff, and sometimes the combat does seem to do weird things that I can't particularly fathom because I most certainly didn't put the controller in that position. But you know what? Nothing feels too unseemly, ungainly. It all sort of pulls together. Beautiful game. I've seen complaints that this game looks ugly. Everyone has their own standards. For me personally, though, I didn't think this game looked ugly. The pre-rendered cutscenes were absolutely amazing in terms of how the characters looked and everything around them. Inside the world, I mean, coming off Yakuza Kiwami, the world blew me away. The first time we walked into Kama Roadshow, it blew me away even more when the training guards were off. I was going to say training wheels, but they weren't really training wheels. They were just sort of guards to guide you in the right direction. But once you get from Kamurocho to Sotenbore, the guards are removed and you can do everything. It astounds me. Sometimes you do run smack bang into a door. I think that's probably a layover from the previous Yakuza games where you get to a door and you have to press a button. Here you just stand in front of the door and Kiryu does an animation of him opening it, which led me to crashing face first into a few doors here and there, but I was still doing it by the end of the game, but by that point I think that was very much a me issue rather than a game issue. But yes, the Dragon Engine's truly astounding as far as I'm concerned. You can run around, you can throw people into shops and then beat them up with all the bar stools. Combat-wise, Kiryu is still the street-fighting badass that he's always been, complete with an arsenal of weapons that you find scattered around. I would complain that the heat actions, though, after having done the secondary completion criteria for the heat actions in the last two games, there seems to be a strong lack of variety in the heat actions in this game. From what I can tell, it's a limitation of Dragon Engine, so take that what you will, I suppose. You take the rough with the smooth, but a lot of heat. I was going into this expecting a whole rainbow of random heat actions, like ripping up electrical boxes or smacking people over the head with lampposts, but some of the tried and true ones, like the bolt shaker and the portable stove, they still exist, as well as the pliers as well. I'm sure many of you are thrilled by that. But I don't know, it seemed lacking in terms of the heat action. However, where they have the lacking of the heat action, you make up for with what I think is brilliant. I think they call it the climax mode. I called it dragon mode or extreme heat mode throughout most of the game, but either way, whatever it's called, once you reach a certain point in the story, you unlock the ability to sort of go Super Saiyan, and you press a button and then Kiryu's pretty much, you can't die so long as you've got a heat bar. It breaks the game slightly after you complete a certain amount of if you do a completion run like I did and you do all of the bouncer missions, then you eventually break the entire system and you can become Immortal Kiryu so long as you're reasonably careful. So there's that. But yeah, the extreme heat mode was an absolute blast to use once I got my head around it. The weapons, I actually used the weapons a lot more in this game than I was expecting to. I was going to go in with a fight, just fist fights, but because unlike previous games where you had a choice of different styles of fighting, and oh, sorry, my PlayStation got off. Right, because you have different styles of fighting in the previous games, here you don't. You only have Kiryu's Dragon of Dojima style, which it's utilitarian. It'll work. It works fine. But the flavor comes from the weapons as well as the extreme heat mode, which is sort of like beast mode in the previous games, where you literally pick up things off the street. I'm still going to complain until my dying day that the mopeds really should not break apart after one hit, but that's neither here nor there. But yeah, combat is perfectly... I found the combat fun for a lot of it. The goons... yeah, I thought it was all right. It was seamless transitions between the fight, from running around to fighting on the street, but I don't know, something felt like it was lacking from Yakuza 0. Maybe it was the extra money you gain from as you beat them up in various ways, but at the same time, context of the game and all that, obviously you're not in the Japanese bubble anymore, so you won't be getting stupid amounts of yen for it, so here and there. But yeah, goons do drop money. If you go to the vending machines, you can get coffee, and that gives you an XP boost or a defense boost, or in my case, I went usually XP or money to help me farm up some money. Money farming, by the way, the return of Club Foreshine. Well, Sunshine from Yakuza 0, but it's called Club Foreshine here. You are a manager of a hostess club. Once again, absolutely brilliant. Absolutely love that. Not because I'm addicted to waifus or anything, but yes, that was an absolute blast to play. The storyline in that was fantastic. No spoilers, but I really highly recommend doing the final hostess mission because, oh, that was very, very fun. What else was the music? Once again, Sega Sound Team completely on point. They have done an absolute stellar job. I will complain bitterly that they have removed Back in the Thai Sorrow as a karaoke song, but they have replaced it with a Majima, well, with an anthem to Majima, as I have named it, just now. Which is absolutely brilliant and has easily become my favourite song in the game. You do have Back in the Thai. You also have a few callback songs that play in the background in restaurants and shops, which is a nice little Easter egg for the people who've played the other games. You also have a few Easter eggs dittered around inside the sub-stories that call back to Yakuza Kiwami and even Yakuza 0 in certain places. Majima is still around, and though he is not everywhere, he is still absolutely amazing. So rejoice, Majima fans! Your mad dog of Shimono is still around. For the Kiryu fans, Kiryu is still an absolute badass and still one of my favorite characters of all time. Story-wise, as I've already said, this game easily goes in as one of my favorites of all time. Story, I won't spoil the story because I think this one is definitely one that you should play. The trailer, watch the trailer for a synopsis of the story, but the story I found absolutely amazing. A lot of the twists and turns I was not expecting. There was one major twist that you can see coming from a million miles away, but other than that aside, there were a lot of smaller twists here, there, and everywhere that led up to the end of it. And only on the second playthrough for the Legend run did it all sort of, I suddenly sort of go, oh right, that ties into there, and that's there, and that foreshadows that, and it was just amazing, and I noticed all these little details you didn't see previous. But then again, hindsight's always 20/20. So yeah, sound design, the characters, what else have we got? I don't think I've forgotten anything, have I? Sub-stories, completion, 100% completion, so... Oh no, not 100% completion, 100% run. We have, over the course of this game, we have done all the main story, all the sub-stories, all of the mini-games, all of the battle and adventure completion. We've done all of the primary completion list. We've all done all of the secondary criteria inside of the completion list. So that's every gear item, every weapon, every heat action carried out. We have also done all of the Club Foreshine missions. We've done all of the Clan Creator missions, main ones, and all but one of the secondary missions. Now, there is a reason for that. Not that it's broken, but I think it's broken, but it's broken by design. The final Clan Creator mission gets you, as far as I can tell, nothing, and it's insanely difficult and requires a lot of grinding, and to be honest, I didn't find it that fun, so I binned that one off. Much like we did with the on-rail shooter section of Yakuza Kiwami,
We are not doing that. We're not completing that particular one on the principle of I just don't have the time, patience, or willpower to do it. Your mileage may vary, but for me personally, no. It didn't have anything to do with the final completion. There we go. The final completion of the game, I'd say it was a completion run if I'd done that, but I didn't, so it's 100% run as far as I'm concerned. We have done all of the things required. We have also platinumed the game. There's no easy way for me to show it, but if you go back through the play to the final, to Journey's End of this Let's Play, then you will find us showing off the Platinum Trophy. So it does exist. Evidence does exist. We have done it. But yes, I think that's enough rambling for now. I think I've covered everything. I think I've got a lot of my thoughts and feelings out for this game. As like I said, I've absolutely adored this game. I have loved it massively. In terms of games, in terms of ranking the Yakuza games, I think this one easily ties with Yakuza 0. Would I say it beats Yakuza 0? That's a tough one. That is a tough sell, but it's certainly up there. I would say those two are some of my favorite games of all time. This one is definitely up there in terms of sub-stories, in terms of main story, in terms of side questing. Oh, and yes, we did, by the way, as part of that completion, of that 100%, do all of the bouncer missions. Pandemonium on Legend. Insane. Insanity. But if you're interested, then somewhere in the archive, there is a video of my final run beating Pandemonium. And yes, it was as stressful as it looked in that video. I think that is everything. I think that is all my thoughts and feelings about this game sort of condensed down into this video. Though if you ever have any questions, do feel free to stop by the live stream and ask me my thoughts on anything in particular. But with that said, for now, I think it is time I have a rest. So to each and every one of you, may you all have a beautiful evening, morning, or afternoon, wherever it is around this whole wide world you are. Thank you very much for listening, and until our paths next cross again, the vortex awaits, and I'll see you all next time. And there we go, that's the fourth video out of the way. Don't know why I do these, but you know what, at least it helps me condense my thoughts down. And if somebody ever does wander through the channel at some point and says, hey Edsia, what did you think of Kingdom Hearts 3,426 days or whatever, then I can point them towards the YouTube archive and say, there's a fourth video about that. And if there's any questions after that, I'm more than happy to answer them. Or I will just answer them in the middle of the stream. I don't know. But either which way, there we go. So, that is the stream going to probably end early, but that is us finished with Yakuza Kiwami 2. It is all done. It's all done, all dusted. And it hasn't been 6 months, so we'll classify that as a win. But there we go. So yes, that is it. Next stop is Deathloop. We only have about 20 minutes of the stream left anyway, so there's no point starting anything else. But you did not play that specific Kingdom Hearts. No, because I've just made that Kingdom Hearts up, my friend. Of course I haven't played it. Why would I? In the furnace, when the next Kingdom, I said, when I finished my Kingdom Hearts run, the Kingdom Hearts franchise run, when the next Kingdom Hearts game comes out, we will definitely play it on the channel. And we did! It was called Melody of Memory, and it was a rhythm game, and it was, alright, I suppose. My fourth videos are in the archive, by the way. I did do a No Holds Barred on Melody of Memory. So, or Memory of Melody, or whatever it is, whatever. We've played all of the Kingdom Hearts games on this channel, all to varying levels of 100% and complete. I've never 100%ed Kingdom Hearts 1, though. Maybe one day we'll go back and we'll 100% Kingdom Hearts 1. Maybe on the 10-year anniversary of this livestream, we will go back and journey to the game where we started it all, and we will 100% Kingdom Hearts 1, complete with my beautiful face on the face cam and a decent microphone setting. But anyway, with that said, it is time that we take a break as we leave the shores of Kamurocho for a brief period. But do not fear, we will be back. After Deathloop, we will return with Yakuza 3. And I'm going to have to fight the urge to say Kiwami 3 for a very long time, I think. But yes, we will continue with Yakuza 3 Remastered,
as we move on to all of the other Yakuza games. I have no idea what to expect from the next Yakuza, I'm going to be honest. I don't know anything about it. I've not seen the trailers. I've not played it. I know Kiryu's in it. That's about the extent, and some Yakuza, apparently. But that's about it. Don't know what engine it's in, don't know how the combat system works, don't know anything about the story or anything. So, I'm going completely blind into that one, so we'll see how it goes. But once again, we've got Deathloop before then, a game that I only know as much as the trailer has shown me. You run around as an awesome dude shooting people in the face and then you die in time reset. That's it. We'll figure it out as we go along, as I'm sure everyone who has played the game has. So, anyway, with that said, if you're new here, hi, I'm Ezio. It's a pleasure to meet you. If you enjoyed what you saw, well, I'd really appreciate it if you hit that follow button, but the decision will always be yours. If you ever want to catch me live, well, I stream here on Twitch every Tuesday and Thursday at 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock UK time, and every Tuesday and Thursday at 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock UK time, depending on how my evening's gone, and every Saturday at 2 o'clock and 7 o'clock UK time. If you've ever missed any of these streams, if you want to see our run of Yakuza Kiwami 2 in full, you can find all these streams uploaded to the VOD section of this very channel, as well as a link to the YouTube archives in the panels down below, containing playlists of every game, every journey as I call them, that we have ever been on this channel. I think that's everything. Everything apart from a thank you to each and every one of you, be you a chatter, be you a lurker, be you watching live here on Twitch or in the YouTube archives, thank you very much for joining me on this journey this evening. Thank you for joining me as we have journeyed through the world this amazing game. And most of all, thank you for spending a little bit of your life here with me on the channel. It means the world. Always will do. Always does. Now, let's see if we've got enough to pay the good vibes forwards. I think we do. So, do we have anyone who is currently live? See you next time. Indeed, Just Razor. Indeed. And you know what? Biafra Republic is live. They have raided us several times. Currently playing Cyberpunk 2077. I have not played that game for a very long time, but we did do a run of it. So, I think we will throw a raid over to Biafra and repay all the time he has raided us. So, Republic playing Cyberpunk, and with that, to each and every one of you, may you all have a beautiful evening, morning, or afternoon, wherever it is around this whole wide world you are, and as always, until our paths next cross again, the vortex awaits, and I'll see you all next time.